Hey everyone, welcome you all. So in the today's video, we are going to see how to check drop-down options or sorted order in Selenium WebDriver. So to do this, we need to apply a small logic. So first let me explain the logic and then we will see the code part. So the first thing is we have a drop-down and let us say which contains some number of options. And we have to prepare two different lists. So one is a original list, the other one is a temporary list. So all the drop-down options we need to capture into original list and also temporary list. So both are having the same options in the same order. So once you capture those options into two different lists, we have to sort this temporary list. So we have to keep the original list aside and we have to sort the options in the temporary list. So after sorting this temporary list, we will get the sorted options. So once you get the sorted options, we will compare these options are equal to original list or not. So if both are equal, then we can say the options are in sorted order. And when you compare with the original list with the temporary sorted list, if both are not equal, then we can say options are not sorted or unsorted. So this is the logic which we have to apply. So let me just explain this by taking some example. Let's say in dropdown, we have ABC, three different options. Now I prepared two different lists. So one is original list, one is temporary list. The original list again is having ABC. Even temporary list is also having EABC. Now we will sort the temporary list. After sorting the temporary list, again, we will get the same ABC after sorting. So here we have to compare this sorted temporary list with the original list. So here we have ABC in the original list. In the sorted temporary list is also have ABC. So both are equal. Then we can say options are in sorted order. Now let me take unsorted. For example, drop-down options are not sorted. Let's say CBA, they are not in sorted order. Now we will prepare two lists. One is original list, one is temporary list. In the original list, we have CBA. Even temporary list also, we have a CBA. Now we will sort the temporary list. So after sorting the temporary list, we will get ABC because we have applied the sorting technique here. And we got the ABC. Now in the temporary list or in the original list, we have CBA, but after sorting temporary list contains the ABC. Now when you compare these two, CBA and ABC options are not equal. So we can say the options are unsorted. So this is a simple logic which we need to apply to check the drop-down options are sorted or not. Now we'll do step by step through programmatically. Now let me open the Eclipse. So before that, let me show you the application. So here I have a small application. Let me open this application. And this is a tuplex.com. And in this application, I have something called live posting. Click on this link. And once you click on this link, you can see a small dropdown here. By default, the value is all. Now, when I expand this, we can see number of options are available. Now, if I want to check these options are in the sorted order or not. Okay, this is my requirement. So let us see step by step how we can see this. So let me open my Eclipse. And this is my Maven project, which is created. And in the pom.xml, we have two dependencies. One is WebDriver Manager. The other one is Selenium Java 4. Now, let me have, I already have one package called my package. So inside this my package, I'm creating the new class. So I'll name it as check drop down sorted or not. Let me take the main method and say finish. All right, so as a first step, we need to set up the driver, browser specific driver, and then we need to launch our application and so on. So for that, what I can do is, first thing I will specify WebDriver Manager, say WebDriver Manager dot Chrome driver dot setup. So this will set up the Chrome driver. And then I'm creating the driver instance. I say web driver, driver equal to new Chrome driver. Now import this web driver element and import this Chrome driver element. All right, so now as soon as you set up the driver, then driver dot get, I'm launching my application URL. So this is my application URL, I'm launching. So once you launch your application, I want to maximize the page. I say driver.manage.window.dot maximize. So this will maximize a browser. Now, as soon as our application is ready in from the home page, so we have to click on this live posting. So let me inspect this element. And if I just go back to the selector hub, which is given some XPath, and we can simply say this is a live posting, and you can say slash slash, which is anchor tag. And here I can specify at the rate, or you can say text, you can verify text equal to say live posting, I guess. Let me just, this is an anchor tag. Yeah, this is a text value. All right, so this is a XPath, which is pointing to the same element, live posting. Now capture this XPath and perform the click action on that element. I say driver.findElement by dot XPath, specify that XPath dot click. So which will perform the click action on the live posting. This is a live posting link. And after that, we will get the dropdown. So here, this is our dropdown. So first, what we have to do is we have to capture all these options from this dropdown. Okay. So here, when I inspect this element, and which is basically available in the selector tag itself, so we can use select class. So first of all, let me get that element. There is an attribute called name. So I'm using the name attribute to get the dropdown element. I say driver.findElement by dot name, specify the name, and this is a dropdown element. I'm storing that into another variable called web element, and I'll say DRP element. So now I have captured that element into a variable. So now we need to pass this element into the select class. So now let me create a new select class instance select, and I can say DRP select equal to new select, and here we have to pass the element. Take this element, you can just pass it. DRP element, and you can pass it here. All right, so now we need to import the select class also. Done. So now we have captured this element, and then we need to get all the options from the dropdown. So to get all the options, what I have to do is DRP select dot, we have a method called get options. So this particular method will return list of web elements. So multiple options in the form of web elements. So what we have to do is, as soon as the get options return all the options, we have to store them in another variable. I'm creating one more variable called options. And this should be list of web element type. Now I capture all the options inside this options variable. Now options contains all the options which are captured from the dropdown. So now by using these options, we have to create two different lists. So as we discussed earlier, once we get the options from the dropdown, we have to prepare two different lists. One is original list, the other one is temporary list. And now in both the list, we need to keep all the options elements. Now what I will do is we have to create a collection type called array list. And here I'll create one variable called original list equal to new array list. Okay, now importing this array list from java.util. This is a collection which can hold multiple objects. And simply, I'm also creating one more array list. This is my temp list. Temp list, both are array list. So once you get all the options into variable, we need to copy these options into two different lists. So two different lists should have the same options. So now what I will do is I will write a simple loop here. I say I'm using for each loop, and here I'm getting the each and individual option from this options variable, and that should be web element option. So from the options, which will read each individual options, each individual option from this and store that into this variable. Option is a web element which can hold a single element. Now, this particular option, from this particular option, I'm getting the text value. I'm getting the text value, and that value I'm storing in both the list. So how we can store it? So we can store like this. So take this original list dot add, and simply specify this options.getText. And the same thing I will store in another array list, which is a temp list. Same thing, temp list dot add. So whatever option element I'm getting here, capturing the text value and storing into both the list. So once this loop is completed, both the list are having the same option elements. So we are not exactly storing the elements. After capturing the text, we are just storing the text value in these two lists. Okay. Now, once the loop is completed, these two array lists contains the text values of every option. So almost both are equal now. Original list and temp list both are equal because we are storing the same option elements into these two array lists. So now what we have to do is we need to keep this original list aside. Then we have to sort the temporary list. So how we can sort the temporary list? So to sort the temporary list, we have to use something called collections dot. There is a method called sort. Okay, so collections is a predefined class which contains a sort option which will sort the collection object. So here temp is a collection object. I'm passing it here. So as soon as I pass the temp list into collection.sort, which is sorted now. So after sorting, the original elements will be sorted into template. Previously here, the elements were different. Now here is different. So after sorting, let me just print the values here before sorting, after sorting. So system.out.println, here I can say original list, I'm just printing the name of the array list. This is the original list. And also I'm printing the temp list. I say temp list. This is a temp list. Okay, so what I have done is all the options I captured and reading each and individual option text values and storing into two array list objects. So once this loop is completed, both the array list contains a value. So now I'm printing those values here, original list and a temporary list. So we'll apply the sorting later. So let's try till here. So original list and temporary list are having same kind of options. And still we haven't applied the sorting technique. I'm just executing this. So now Chrome driver was started successfully. Launching my application, then maximizing it, clicking on the live, and then I think we got. Now let me go back to the Eclipse. Yes, now we can see this is the original list and this is the temporary list. So having the same options. Okay, now we have to sort the temporary list. Okay, we need to keep the original list aside. We have to sort the temporary list. After sorting, we have to compare with the original sort. So now here I'm applying this method collections.sort and temp list. So once it is sorted, is done. So here this is a sorting. So this is a direct method which is available. Sort is a direct method which is available in the collections. And whichever the collection object we have passed, which will automatically sort all the collection objects. All right, so once it is sorted, now we need to compare. So how to compare it? But before comparison, I am again now printing the list. So original list, still it will be the same before or after sorting because we are not changing the original list. Original is the same. But temp list after sorting. After sorting. So original list after sorting, it will be same. So here I'll say original list after sorting. After. So we are not sorting the original list actually. So I'm just printing the original list as it is. So before applying the sorting, original list, temporary list we have printed. Now I'm applied sorting only on the temporary list. So original list will be as it is. And temporary list I'm printing after sorting. Now let us try to execute here. And later we will compare original list and sorted list. Now it is launching my browser, opening my URL, maximized. Yeah, now it went to drop down. Now we'll see here. Now we can just hear original list is not changed, it is same. We have sorted only the temporary list. So here you can see this is a temporary list. After sorting, this is a temporary list now. So accommodation, travel, all animals, so this is actual sorted data. Okay, so now what we have to do is we have to compare original list with sorted temporary list. So both values are exactly the same, then our drop-down options are in sorted order. If both are not same, then options are unsorted. So we have to apply one condition here. So for that, what I can do is we'll write one if condition. If, so how to compare two array list, original list and temporary list, we have to compare. So original list dot equals, and we have to pass another one, temporary list. So original list dot equals temporary list. If both are equal, what I have to say? I say system dot out dot println. So drop down. I say drop down sorted. If both are equal, right? If both are not equal, then else I say drop down unsorted. Drop down unsorted. So after that, I can close my browser. I say driver.close. So this is how we need to check. So let me explain again, once again. So first we have to capture all the options from the dropdown and store the options in two different array list. And we are not exactly storing the options. We are capturing the text value of those options, and we are storing the only text values into both the array list. Then original list we will keep aside. Now we are sorting the temporary list. So after sorting the temporary list here, we again compare the temporary list with the original list. Then if are both are equal, then options are in sorted order. If both are not equal, then options are in unsorted order. So this is the logic which we have applied. Okay, now let me execute the code once again. Now we'll see whether the dropdown is sorted or not. Now starting my Chrome driver and then launching my browser, opening my application URL and clicking on live posting. And once it is done, dropdown is opened. Yeah, once it is done, page is automatically closed. So now we can see here dropdown unsorted, because the options are in the dropdown is not in the sorted order. Now we can check the details also here. So initially this is a original list and this is a temporary list. And what we have done, we have applied the sorting technique on the temporary list. So now the sorted temporary list will become like this. Now, which is comparing with the original list. So original list and sorted list, sorted temporary list options are not in the same order. So dropdown is unsorted. Dropdown is unsorted. So this is how we can verify the dropdown options are sorted or not. So here we use two different array list to store the option text values. And then finally we will compare. So we have to apply the sorting method only on the temporary list, because which will automatically change the temporary list. So once you sorted, again, we cannot get back the original list. Initially original list and temporary list is having same values, but after applying the sorting on the temporary list, the original list will be modified. The original list will be sorted. So original list will not be sorted. In the temporary list, after applying the sorting technique on the temporary list, now the temporary list will be modified. So then the temporary list will be compared with the original list. If both are equal, then we can say sorted. Both are not equal, then we can say unsorted. All right, so this is how we can check the dropdown options are sorted or not. All right, so in the next video, we will see a few more questions. So that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching.